Hello, this training is on how to submit an electronic invoice or e-invoice with all conditions being correct. This training is brought to you by the Web-Based Supply Chain Management or WBSCM team. This video will cover how to submit an electronic invoice with the conditions being the advanced shipping notification and goods receipt quantities match, along with the delivery not being late. An example of conditions matching is the ASN quantity was entered for 1,200 cases, the goods receipt quantity was entered for 1,200 cases, and the delivery date was August 9th, 2019, which was inside the no later than delivery window on the purchase order. An important note before continuing, the ASM must have been created first before you are able to process an e-invoice. The process for creating an ASN has not changed. Please refer to instructions found on our website on how to create an ASN if unfamiliar with this process. You can find instructions by navigating to https://www.ams.usda.gov/selling-food/WBSCM. I will now move to WebSCM to demonstrate how to submit an e-invoice. Log into WebSCM as you normally would and follow the portal path Suppliers, Supplier Self-Service, then e-invoices for processing. To make my view larger, I'm going to click on Full Screen found on the right-hand side of the page. From this page, you have the ability to search through various methods. As you can see, you can search by ASN number, purchase order, in-line item number, shipment status, and receipt status, along with various other methods. In this example, we are going to search by purchase order number. I'll be using the example 41000-7477. Once you have entered in your number, scroll to the bottom and select search. You are directed to the worklist tab that shows all the line items associated with this PO. In this situation, we are looking for line item 2. Review the data available to you. It will display the purchase order number, line item number, and additional information that you can find if you scroll to the right. So for in this example, we can see that the quantity delivered was 660 cases, and the receipt quantity was 660 cases, and we know that this delivery was made on time. We'll scroll back to the left. To continue processing, highlight the row by selecting the gray box to the left, as I had just done. Then click on Further Actions. You'll be taken to a new tab titled Additional Details with a subtab Vendor Shipments. Under the Vendor Shipments tab, check the box Process Further. Click on the Add Attachments tab to add any attachments that should be associated with this line item. A list of mandatory attachments appear on the left-hand side of the screen. If the required files are not attached to the shipment receipt, the vendor will be unable to confirm the receipt. Mandatory documents can be attached as separate files or merged into one PDF file. Word documents and Excel files can be uploaded as well. As we can see in this example, there are two documents that are mandatory, checkloading certificate and proof of delivery. To highlight the attachment type, click on the document. So for this example, we're going to select checkloading certificate found in the attachment type box. When you have highlighted it, select Browse and look for the file that you wish to upload. In this example, I will click on Testing Document, select Open, then click on Add Attachment. If you scroll up, you can see that you'll have a green checkbox appear for you, letting you know that your document was successfully uploaded. Again, as we can see, there are two documents that were mandatory to be uploaded. So now I need to upload Proof of Delivery. I will scroll down and find Proof of Delivery and highlight it by clicking on it. I will select Browse. Then I will highlight my document I want to upload, select Open, then click on Add Attachment. Once you are satisfied with all the attachments and that there are no further attachments to be included with this line item, select Done, which can be found in the middle of your page. You will be brought back to your Additional Details tab with the subtab Vendor Shipments. If not already done so, check the Further Process button. As you can see, there are certification questions. Certification questions are mandatory and must be answered before you can submit your e-invoice. If the answer to any of the required questions is no, the shipment is routed to USDA for approval upon confirmation. In this example, we will select Yes. The vendor reference field is for the vendor's internal reference number, but this is not mandatory. In this example, I will enter in a number. Additionally, you may enter in any comments in the comments field section, but again, this is not mandatory. When you are done entering attachments and have answered the certification questions, click on Submit to create the e-invoice. You have completed the process for submitting an e-invoice. This will shortly change the receipt status to auto-approved. When an e-invoice has been auto-approved, this means that USDA does not need to review the e-invoice and what you have just submitted will go straight through for payment. If you have any questions, please contact the WBSCM Help Desk. Their email is wbscmamshelpdesk@usda.gov. Thank you, and this concludes the training on how to submit an electronic invoice.